Welcome, beautiful soul, to our yoga practice for an open heart and a curious spirit. Today, we embark on a journey to awaken and activate the powerful energy center located at the solar plexus, our third chakra. This is associated with our sense of self, personal power, and confidence. As we move through our practice, we'll focus on postures and breath work that ignite the fire in our belly, stoking these flames of confidence, self-worth, and transformation. This class is designed to be all-level friendly, offering variations to meet you wherever you're at. Beginning today with a moment to center ourselves. Standing tall at the top of your mat, finding mountain pose, Tadasana. Standing hip distance apart, grounding down through the feet, feeling the earth beneath you. Beginning to engage your thighs, lifting the chest, drawing a big energetic line up through the crown of the head as you begin to bring awareness to your breath. Inhale, reach the arms up to the sky, palms meet, exhale, draw them into the heart. Breathing nice and deeply. Feeling the energy within, the energy that surrounds. Find yourself in this moment, meeting yourself with compassion and love. Taking another moment to cleanse and reaching up once more when you're ready. Inhale, grab the left wrist, stepping the left leg behind, finding a nice big stretch on the side of the body. Lifting your heart towards the sky, already thinking thoughts of expansion and openness. Carefully stepping back to center and reaching up to grab hold of the right wrist as you step the right leg back. Finding as much length as you can. Releasing back to center, exhale, release the arms. Inhale, reach them up, crossing the left arm underneath the right, trying to meet palms for eagle arms. Taking these first few breaths to find your position and allow a gentle opening of the back. Awareness is in between the shoulder blades as you stand tall. Inhale, reach the palms up, and exhale, round through the back, tucking the chin. Taking about 3 rounds of breath like this. Moving carefully and slowly. Inhale and exhale. On your next in-breath, reach up. Exhale, slowly unravel, opening to cactus arms, lifting the chest high as you reach the elbows back. Big, full breaths. Open the lungs. And exhale, return to center, coming into eagle arms on the other side. bringing attention back to the body and the breath if the mind begins to wander. Enjoying this time for yourself to just be you. Rounding, opening up the spine before we prepare for a few rounds of Sun Salutation A. Releasing the arms, finding another breath in cactus. And inhale, reach up. Exhale, dive down, flat back. Inhale, lift halfway, extend through the crown of the head, fingertips float up. Exhale, round through the back, plant the palms, step back carefully into plank. We can lower the knees here if we like. Chaturanga, chest towards the mat. Inhale, lift it up. Exhale, connect to the core, lift the knees and the hips, downward facing dog. Bend the knees, take a moment to wake up the legs, and carefully come back to the top of the mat. Inhale to lift halfway, exhale, fold. Root to rise, big breath in, hands reach. Taking another round, making sure to move in your own time. Waking up the body, linking breath to movement, taking any modifications you need. And when you're here in downward facing dog, find your way to the top of the mat. And find one last Sun Salutation A. I invite you to make this one a little bit faster. Invite some heat. Invite some fire. Igniting your physical energy. Finishing your last Sun Salutation and meeting back in Mountain Pose at the top of the mat whenever you're ready. Making sure not to rush. Finding a breath. Inhale, exhale. Ground down through the right foot as you bring the left knee into the chest, carefully stepping it to the back of the mat, coming into a nice high lunge. Sweep the arms up once you've found your footing, reaching the left heel back. Waking up the legs, feeling nice and strong in your lower body support. Inhale. And on your next out-breath, carefully turn to Warrior Two. Really ground down through the back foot. Feel the connection. Draw the shoulder blades together, nice big warrior stance, take up space. Inhale, reverse the warrior, right arm comes high overhead. Balancing ease and effort. Finding another breath before carefully switching back through, facing the right leg and lifting up into Warrior Three. Take your time. Really activate through the glutes and the quadricep. Finding your focus point and embody the confidence within your core. Face these challenges with strength. You know you have it. With as much control as you can, replace the back foot down on the mat and exhale to rain the left fingertips down, coming into a full high twist. Still lifting the hips up, controlling our body as we control our minds. Staying here, or we have an option to lift up into a prayer twist, pressing the palms together to really deepen the wringing out. Wringing out any self-doubt. Letting go on this exhale. Carefully releasing, dropping the left knee, and reaching for the back foot, kicking the heel up. Pulling it into the hips as you lift up. Feeling a nice stretch in the front of the left thigh. Taking this moment to connect. Exhale, release. Plant the fingertips, nice high runner's lunge. And step up into chair pose. Beautiful. Sweep those arms up. Big inhale and exhale. Sink the hips. Relax the shoulders by the ears. Hold here. Lift the heels on your exhales. Find as many as you can. I know you can do 5. Can you do 10? Feeling your muscles become stronger. Beautiful. And coming back through a nice sturdy chair pose to release into mountain. Take a moment to shake out the legs, preparing for the other side. Inhale, big reach up, and exhale, heart center. We can choose to take a few breaths here, or maybe you'd like another vinyasa. Make this practice your own. You know what comes next. Stepping up, the right leg back into our high lunge. Nice and steady. Use the transitions as a pose in itself. Expand the lungs as you keep your chest forward, standing tall in your power. And exhale, channel your inner warrior. Fingertips spread wide. Facing everything as it comes. Inhale and exhale. Finding your reverse warrior. Opening up your heart to all possibilities that will unfold before you. And windmilling around, coming into your nice strong balance, taking your time to get there. Engage your core, connect to your inner strength. Believe in yourself. Stepping back, high lunge, and finding your big open body twist. Find as much space in the body as you can. And taking the same variation as you did on the previous side. Staying where you're at, or coming into a prayer twist. Feeling your breath flow in and out, invigorating mind and body. Releasing back, framing the left leg as you drop the right knee. Reaching for the heel, pulling it into the hips. We can always extra pad our mat by rolling it, using a blanket. We can use a yoga strap here if we can't reach the foot. Not hunching over, take one big breath, sitting up nice and tall. And carefully, lovingly release the foot and come through your runner's lunge. Lifting back up into chair pose. One more time, you can do it. Sink those hips down. Don't shy away from me now. 10 more heel lifts. If your mind tells you you can't, let your body prove it wrong. You got this. Maybe finding some enjoyment out of the exertion. Beautiful. See if you can hold for a second or two on the last one. And then drop your booty down. Plant the hips down on the mat, raising the shins, boat pose. A little bit more work to do in the core. Lifting the chest up towards the knees, seeing how close you can get your body. Use your breath, don't hold it. Release down into a low boat pose if you dare. Holding here for a few breaths. Really squeezing the abdomen, come back up into high boat. Find a little movement. This will really get your stabilizer muscles, your obliques. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes. You can feel super, super good and accomplished now and release into an easy seat. Find a few moments here, some hip circles. Let your body tell you what it needs. Feel free to move away from my guidance and listen to your own intuition. Beginning to cool down the body, but not forcing your breath to move in any particular rhythm or manner. Finding a few more breaths before we carefully finish our flow in a grounding child pose. Taking big toes together at the back of the mat, planting the fingertips down in active child pose, reaching the fingertips out wide, feeling a nice stretch in the shoulders and the arms, perhaps the chest. Reaching the left arm up on an in-breath, and exhale, thread the needle coming under the right arm, finding a gentle twist. Allowing your breath to relax your lower back. And calm down the mind. Taking a big breath in through the nose. Exhale softly. And carefully pressing back up when you're ready to replace your hands. Peeling the right arm up and exhale to thread it underneath the left. Hugging your lower body closely. Connecting back to your solar plexus chakra. Sitting right behind your navel. See if you can send your breath there. Breathing fully from the belly. Releasing your twist and coming into a nice, relaxing child pose, surrendering any residual tension wherever you may find it. Bringing your awareness once again to the solar plexus, sitting just above your navel. Visualizing a bright yellow light radiating from your abdomen, affirming your inner power and self-expression. Find a few moments to breathe and connect with this revitalized energy. Staying here as long as feels necessary and healing for you. And whenever you're ready, gently open your eyes, lift the chest back up, feeling renewed and empowered. Take a big breath in and exhale. As we seal this practice in together, I hope you enjoyed the journey of self-discovery and expression that we brought through this solar plexus chakra yoga flow. Thank you so much for joining me on the mat today. I look forward to the next time we meet. Now go out there and be the best you.